Hello friends, this is HowISolve.com and this is your tech expert Neil. In this video, I will show you how you can root any Nexus device step by step. So stay tuned. Before we begin this video, I'd like to share that we have got a video index down in the video description. If you want to skip to a particular part of the video, you can check that out and skip to that section. Also, if you prefer a written version to this video, we have got an article on our blog, which you can see by clicking on this eye icon over here at the top right corner. If you are facing some problem following this guide, then we have got a forum on our blog and you can ask for help over there. You can access the forum by clicking on the eye icon that you can see on the top. Click on that icon if you are facing some problem. Okay, with that, let us begin this tutorial. Currently, there are several ways to root Android devices, and one of the popular ones are the one-click root solutions that don't require PC. I had tried one of these methods, namely the king root method with a Nexus 5 LG, but unfortunately that didn't work on it. It worked to root the device, but after rooting there was some bug due to which battery indicator stopped working properly. So I have to again unroot it and reroot it using this method, at which I am going to show you. This method is not a one-click solution, but it is much safer than those one-click solutions that uses backdoors and security vulnerabilities to get root access to your device. So I prefer this method, even though it's not the most convenient and it might take certainly more than a click to achieve root, but it's reliable and safe. I'd like to thank the developers of this software which we'll be using in this guide. So a huge thanks to Wugfresh for developing this great software, Nexus Toolkit. Now let's look at the prerequisites. You will require a USB data cable to connect your Nexus device to the PC, and you will require the Nexus Toolkit software, which you can download by clicking on the links in the video description. So let's go to the website and download the tool. If you open the link given down in the video description, then this page would open, and if you scroll down over here in the download section, you'll find this link given over here, NRT version 2.1.9. The version number might change later on. We'll download it by clicking on this link. After the download finishes, you'll find one exe file. This I've already downloaded, so we'll install this toolkit now. To install it, double click it. It'll ask you for the location for installation. I'll keep it at the default location, that is program files. Click on install. It'll ask for administrative rights. Click yes, and now the installation process will begin. It will take around 2 to 3 minutes depending on your system configuration. At this point, I would like to point out that there was some problem when I installed it the first time, where the toolkit updates got stuck and I had to use ntask to get it back working. So if you are facing some similar issue, and just head to task manager, and then over here you will find the update, Nexus toolkit update here, Wugfresh development updater. At this time also it is looking like it's hung because it's consuming all the resource system CPU resources. So I'll wait. If you don't see the toolkit working, then just end task this process, Wugfresh development updater, and then this tool will start working. So I'll wait for 5 minutes. Okay, I've waited for 5 minutes, but still this process is not finished. So I think that it got stuck. So I'll use ntask to kill this process. And as soon as I did that, the tool proceeded. So mind that. Anyway, so now we have finished with the step one. Now let's proceed to step two. Step two is to get your device model number and build number. So to do that, head to your device and go to the settings, that is at the top. You'll find this banner icon, tap on that, go right to the bottom in about phone section, and there you'll find the build number and your model number. Okay, in my case it is Nexus 5 and the build number is M4B30Z. I'll just input those two things. So Nexus 5, it's an LG Nexus 5, yeah, and build is M4, so we'll go down here, M4B30Z, this last one. Okay, also if you are not able to find the build number in the list provided, You can select any build in this list. That is the last option. Okay, since my build is present in the list, so I'll select it and then I'll click apply. Now it will list down the steps for enabling USB debugging on your device. So I'll perform those steps right now. Okay, so first thing that you have to do is you have to enable developer mode. If you have already enabled developer mode on your device, so then this is not required. But if not, then check this out. Just go to the settings and the about phone section and just tap on the build number 3 to 4 times, and now it will mention you are now a developer. So with that, you have enabled developer mode, so that will allow you to access the developer settings. So again, go back to the settings, and then over here you will see the developer options. So tap on developer options, and then under debugging you will find USB debugging. So just turn that on. It will confirm your action. Click OK. Okay, now we have enabled USB debugging, which is required for this application to work. Now let's see what else it says. Okay, so this step is finished. Now let's proceed to the next step. It looks like the application has again hung, so I'll again end task. Okay, so there's some problem. I think it might be because of the virtual machine I'm using. Anyway, if you face similar issue, just go to your task manager and end task, the updater task. Okay, so this is the main interface. It might look a bit complicated, but it's not that difficult. In fact, this toolkit provides you each and every instruction before it performs any operation. Quite good. Now let's start with the initial setup stage, that is here. So in this step, we'll install the drivers, USB drivers for your phone. So for that, just click on this full driver installation guide, automatic plus manual button. Okay, in this there will be a couple of steps mentioned. If you have installed any previous drivers on this system, then the first step is to uninstall them. So we'll just skip this and straight away go to step 3, that is considering that you have not installed any drivers for your phone on the system ever. Okay, so in step 3 it says choose a driver solution. If the recommended doesn't work, try 4. Okay, so it's saying that for this particular device the recommended driver solution is driver solution 1. So in that case it is Google drivers over here. This might be different depending on your device, but it will be one of these 5 options. Since my case it says get Google drivers, so I'll click on this. Just click OK. This will install the Google drivers required for your particular device. Click connect at the installation. Click finish. Okay, so now the driver installation has finished. Now let's proceed to step 4. So confirm your drivers are configured properly. So for that, now we'll test the driver installation and the USB debugging settings. So just connect your device. So I'll just connect mine. After connecting, click on this full driver test button. Make sure that you have enabled USB debugging that I had mentioned previously. On the screen you will see this dialog, allow USB debugging. So click, check this box, always allow from this computer, and click on OK. Okay, now we will run this full driver test. It's checking the ADB connection, and whatever it's doing it will mention in this live log. So now as you can see, it's saying that it's rebooting your device into bootloader mode. Now it's checking fast boot connectivity, again rebooting the device. Now we'll wait for the device to reboot. It'll take a couple of minutes. Device detected. As you can see, the driver test was successful. So we are done with the driver installation and testing part. Now we can proceed to the next part of this tutorial. That is, before we root it, we'll require to back up your device, because you will require to wipe your device since we'll be unlocking the bootloader, and this process requires you to wipe the entire device. Under backup plus restore, click on backup and then click on create Android backup. Okay, this will create the backup for all the apps except the apps that are system or having shared data, which includes multimedia files from your SD card. We'll back those up separately. So we'll create an Android backup file, click OK. It will ask you to where do you want to save it. Just check the default path, it's in documents. So fine, I'll just select the default path and click save. It will reboot your device, and if you want you can back up the contact, SMS and call logs also. So it's asking unlock the screen and hold your device. If you wait too long, after you initiate the backup it won't work. While it backs up, click OK. So over here we can see that it's doing some backup, a full backup of all the data. So the screen is coming up. If you wish to encrypt, so you can enter a password. I'll keep no password and click backup my data. Backing up starting. So as you can see, the backup has completed. In total, it backed up 39 MBs of data, 40 MBs of data approximately. If you want to backup all your media, then you have to do a manual backup. There's no other option. You back all the files on the SD card and then remove it before you unlock this bootloader, because on unlocking it will be wiped completely. So now we will continue with the rooting process. For that, we'll have to unlock the bootloader. To unlock the bootloader, as it's been mentioned clearly here, this will wipe your device, so make a backup first. So I'm being very clear here, do not proceed if you have got some data on the phone and you have not done any backup of that data. So with that warning, let's proceed with unlocking the bootloader. It will give you a big warning. This script will unlock your device, enabling you to root it and ultimately allowing you to gain full access to your Android operating system. This includes, but it is not limited to, being able to modify your radio baseband. In a long description of what we are doing, so just click OK, reboot your device. Since my device is already unlocked, it will show this message, but in your case it will perform all the steps required for unlocking it, including wiping of the device. After performing this step, your device would be unlocked and now prepared for root. So when your device restart, after that we'll head to rooting this device. I'll wait for my device to restart. Okay, my device is up and running. Before performing root, we'll just check whether we have got all the updates. So click on the update and click automatic update. Okay, now as you can see, it's suggesting me there are some updates available. Most of the time this update doesn't get downloaded automatically and you have to download it manually. I'll show you that method, but let's try it today whether it works, automatic download works or not. So let's see. These are basically the custom recovery that will be temporarily enabled to just root your device, and this application is the main super user application which will provide you the root access to your device. It's required that it should be the most updated version so that your device functions properly. We'll wait for this download to finish. Okay, the TWRP recovery has been downloaded successfully. Now let us download the Chainfire SuperSU application. Again, click on download plus update all file dependency. As you see, it's not allowing me to download. You click continue and then it will say to get the file from here. So we'll just download it from this link, but most probably, yeah, it's working. Sometimes this link also doesn't work. So in that case, you just Google this file name and then you should find the required file. But at this time, it looks like it is just found it. Yeah, click on this begin download button. Okay, the SuperSU app now has been downloaded successfully. I'll just select it so that we can continue the routing process. Here, click apply and it will do a hash check to verify whether the file has been downloaded properly. As you can see, the hash check has been successful. Now it's importing the file into the installer. We'll head back to our Nexus Toolkit program. Okay. Now since we have got the updated version of both TWRP and SuperSU, now we can head to rooting our phone. For rooting the device, click on this button over here, and if you want to install a custom recovery, you can check this box. Custom recovery is useful in case you are planning to install custom ROMs in your device, or if you are a power user and just want to have more control over your device, then also you can install custom recovery. But for a normal user, it's not that required, so I'll not install it. I'll keep this unchecked. Just click on this root button over here. This will start the root process, so it will just mention all the things that we have already performed. Just go through it, it's just says what all things would be performed, nothing to worry about. Click OK. It's now checking whether it has got the USB connectivity set. Just keep an eye on this live log, which will show what all things is happening. As you can see, it has rebooted the device in bootloader mode and now it's checking fastboot connectivity. Now it's booting TWRP. The device will reboot many times, so don't worry. It's pushing the root files and it has verified. Now it's saying it's pushing, and I guess everything is done, almost rebooting a device. Okay. So it says that we have successfully installed. You just have to perform one more step that will be done on the device. Granting VisiBox super user permissions, updating and installing it. So we'll just do that right now. So go to your device. Yeah, you'll just do the busybox installation here. This is the busybox process. Since I've already installed it previously, it's not asking me, but in your case it will ask for super user permission. So just grant it the permission and then click on the install button over here. So it will just install it like that. With that, you'll have a fully properly rooted Nexus device. I hope this video helped you. If yes, smack that like button. Please support us. To support us, you can share this video with your friend whom you think could benefit from this video. At HowISolve.com, we provide you with the latest technology updates, tutorials, tips and tricks, troubleshooting guides, and much more. Subscribe to our YouTube channel to get similar videos in the future. Thanks for watching, friends. See you later. Bye.